for one, I am happy with friends. I consider you, all of you, my friends. And let me just give you the salutations. The newly appointed government officials and Philippine councillors of the League officers, my fellow workers in government, my beloved countrymen. As always, at this time, I am in the process of just complying with the five simple promises that I made during the campaign, and no big deal except about corruption, drugs, and criminality, which is really pulling us down, and of course, the economic. I have been very frank with you that I am not good at economics, though I had some learnings about it, but not as good as running maybe a city, but not a country. And so, nagdispensa ako dyan, ang sinabi ko na, for the things that hindi ko kaya, ibigay ko sa mga tao na may kakayan. At yun namang mga bagay-bagay na, which I believe kaya ko, kagaya ng law and order, maybe it's because I have been the mayor of Davao City for so long, 23 years, that's why I got to learn all the things about the wherewithals of a peaceful community. At sa bagay na yan, I can only point to Davao City as the only thing na ikapagyabang ko sa inyo na hindi naman masyadong maganda na talagang terribly, terribly peaceful, but hindi naman talaga magulo. And it has allowed us to grow to an unprecedented growth rate of 9, which is unheard of this country. Talagang pumuputok ang Davao. At nandoon lahat, papunta ang pera. Now, dito sa ibang mga promises ko, ito lang ang masabi ko. Lahat kayong Pilipino na may gustong tumulong sa bayan natin, if you really want to help improve this country, and if you want us to rise a little bit of the yung ano natin sa nakaraan, now is the time. Now is the time because I am really with you. Sa graft and corruption, I have a zero tolerance. And quietly, so I ilang pinaalis ko na sa gobyerno, marami na, about 92, especially yung mga regulatory boards. Andiyan yung talagang pigaan sa corruption. Ang akin lang kasi, wala naman ako ipagmalaki. I do not have the credentials. But I can do some things just like what I did in Davao. Maybe parang tin plate ko. So, kung gusto ninyong tapusin yung corruption, and of course, yung droga ibigay na ninyo sa akin, hindi naman ako nagyayabang. Sa ating generation ngayon, the present crops of politicians and those workers of government, medyo ako lang ang makahirit dyan. Itong corruption na ito, kasi it involves a lot of ang sakit ng loob ko dyan sa droga is because it has destroyed a lot of the lives of my countrymen. And talagang sirang-sira, it's a very good estimate, about 4 million has had or have had the experience of using drugs. How many of them are really insane now? I really do not know. I do not have the numbers. But what I know is that the constant use of shabu, which is really a deadly chemical, would shrink the brain of a person. That's according to the American forensics. unlike cocaine and heroin, it takes a lot for the properties to break up inside the cells. Kasi papi, it's organic. Chemical itong meth. And sabi nila, if the brain has shrunk to a considerable degree, rehabilitation is no longer possible. And maalaala ko lang kasi because I have been around, and I am also one of those na hindi naman talagang may pera tayo sa buhay. Na, alam mo, I've been to so many places. I've been to places like the Middle East. The husband is working in one country. The wife is in another country. And there's so many sad stories that I hear about our women being raped, abused sexually. Tsaka yung mga asawa, they work their ass to death just to earn a few hundred or $2,000 to send back to sa pamilya nila. And to think uniform yan eh. That uniform talaga yan. Pagdating dito, ang tulog lang nila is 3 to 4 hours. Tapos lamaw minsan ang kinakain. And this is not surprising kasi doon, in many countries, I would not go into specifics. Pag empleyado ka ng isang pamilya at yung kapatid ng asawa, wala silang helper, magtrabaho ka pa doon. And if it is a compound, nandoon yung son-in-law, magtatrabaho ka pa rin. So matatapos sila minsan, sunrise na, or a little bit of the breaking of darkness, doon na sila matutulog 2-3 oras. Kaya yung iba out of sheer desperation, kapakamatay, lumulokso doon sa bintana. And to think of the abuse endured at saka yung hirap na tapos ipadala ang pera dito sa kanilang mga anak only to find out in dismay na pagbalik nila, ang anak nila, nagunggong na siya sabo, or the daughter rape or into also the drugs. And for the years that they have been there in toil, just like slaves, no different from the slaves bought from the slaves market of Africa. Diyan ako na umiinit talaga. Meron mo kayong mga maraming taga Davao, sila Dani ng Hirang, yung league, ano ninyo. Talagang umiinit ako. That is why, nung mayor ako, nakita ko yung impact. I made no bones about my hatred and I said, if you do drugs in my city, if you destroy our daughters and sons, I'll just have to kill you. I repeated the same warning nung na-presidente ako. And rightly so. Yun ang dapat ang slogan ni Ring, talagang gawin mo. Kasi with 4 million, I really do not know kung ilan ang gunggong dyan. At in criminal law kasi, if somebody is accused of a crime, and I am the lawyer, and I think that he's off his rockers, all that I have to do at the start of the trial is to make a motion for a preliminary examination on the condition of the mind, of the mental faculties of the accused. Now, he might have been still good when he committed the crime. But at the time he is tried for the crime, for his deed, sabihin ng doktor, wala na yan. Kita mo kung ano nang pinagsasagot-sagot. Then he goes free. Though he is insane. Or gunggong na noon, tapos when he committed the crime, gunggong pa ngayon. You know, alam mo, kung maniwala kayo dyan sa mga, ano, huwag yung sa newspaper, pati yung, maraming ano dyan, virulent ang ano, lalo na yung istasyon na talo yung EBS, Inquirer, na talo yung kandidato nila. They become really vicious and virulent. Ganun niya, babasa mo, kita mo, ano, talagang tinotwist nila. Yung slant na slant, sinasadya na they do not complete the sentence and they just zero in on the adjective or kung ano ang, however you describe the situation. Ganon niya, those are the persons na wala na silang nakita sa bundong ito na maayos. And that would also give you the, itong mga mayaman ng mga elite. Galit sila pag talo yung kandidato nila. And just like the other administration. So hindi ko naman nila pinapakinggan, hindi ko naman binabasa, except of course yung factual news kung ano nangyari itong araw na ito. Pero yung mga opinion writer, there are a lot of us talaga, us in us. So, okay lang sa akin yan because I've been, and si Inday Santiago, I've been mayor of Davao for 23 years. Kinakain ko yung mga atake na atake. Yun ang, but if you just want the truth, just read us once, no more. At we don't have an obligation to lie. Kaya hindi ako nagsisinungaling, but abet anong utang ko sa Pilipinas na would compel me to voice the lie. For what? Di sabihin ko, natuloy yung totoo para malaman yung, ito yung totoo. I do not go into that kind of rigmarole na maraming istorya. Diretso ako. Itong droga, pati itong mga iyo, putang. You know, if they would ask you how I would describe them, just tell them that the mayor has said you're a fucking shit. Alam mo, doon sa ano nila, bagong material na pinadala, that instead of killing them, which I am not also inclined to do every time, na magtayo na lang tayo ng centers, if he wants shabu, we give it to him. Then he wants cocaine, bibigyan rin natin. So there must be some all over the town, they want to set up clinics and distribute shabu, marijuana, kima medicinal o kaya ano, para kagaya daw sa kanila doon. State of Washington, pati yung mga gunggong talaga, putang inasabi mo. You know, when a guy is crazy, how many times have you read? Binaso niya ang lola niya dahil the guardian angel was whispering to him, kill your lola because he's evil. Mga inutil itong puti, putang ina niya. So, totoo lang. Eh, I'm forced to, alam mo, pag ganon ang salita, although it is not expressed in terms of gutter language or slang, street slang, the proposal itself is odious to me. It's despicable, actually. Kaya binababoy ko itong mga ulul na ito. Naloko ba kayo? And you know, we must also realize that itong mga iyo do not so be so parang pontifications ninyo. For after all, you are ahead of the industrialization age. Why? Because you conquered lands. You got the oil of the Arabs to build your industries way ahead than ours. Dito so far as you conquered Indonesia, Malaysia, the Philippines. got the best of our lands, live off with the fat of the lands, and you think now that you are the educated one and you should be listened to. And you come up with this morality, do not impose your whatever it is, your values and everything, because we hate you for being a hypocrite. You are the incongruity of the times. Kung sila noon, pinagpapatay nila in Mindanao, they massacred the so many Moro na lumaban. And to think of it, they never conquered Jolo. Nobody set foot on Jolo. And that is why still is surprised until now, bakit ang Jolo kasali? Mindanao, yes. Sambuanga, yes. But walang dumating doon sa Jolo na Katsila? Ang Amerikano. But marami silang minasakir. Yung sa Samar, just because a colonel was tinantad ng waray doon, was a time when they killed all the males, 10 and above, they massacred them. Tapos magsalita sila ngayon about human rights. You come to think of it, itong Amerika has been threatening me with the prosecution sa International Criminal Court. Go ahead. Tapos, basa-basa ako, yung pala sila hindi member ng International Criminal Court. Do you know why? Because if they do that, if they were a signatory, the boss, the son, pati yung tatay would go to jail. Remember that they invaded a country just because of drugs. Never mind about the killing. A sovereign country invaded by the United States, Panama. Because sabi nila si Noriega was pumping so many tons of drugs. Then they waged war against the Middle East. Wala namang kasalanan ang mga Muslim doon. But they had the, yung mga strong man. They did not like Saddam. Then they came up with the pretext that there was weapons of mass destruction, only to find none. Then they started to erode the, pati na ang Libya, Syria, and all. Saan yan sila pumasok, sira ang mundo. Vietnam was lucky. It won the war after so many years, and they are very prosperous now. Kaya itong Amerika na ito, hindi ko maintindihan. Obama, well, the human rights used to criticize me when I was mayor. But when I was already the president, it started with the human rights, the State Department, the Office of the President of the United States, yung babae, pati si Obama. And they chastised me. Sabi ko, putang ina kayo. Ikaw, Obama, go to hell. Ikaw, sabi ko, mukhang puta ka, umalis ka dyan. Why? Noon, okay lang yung mayor ako. But when I became president, I was carrying the sovereignty of the nation. Who are you to chastise me like that? Putang ina kang Obama haga. Go to hell. Oh, sumikat patuloy ako. Now, I'll tell you. Anong asal ng Amerikano gusto nilang putang ina nila? Anong asal na gusto nila? Because Obama was reprimanding me in public. He was this, ito si Obama, it's a... ang utak nito, sisirayan ang mundo nito, maniwala kayo. Yung ano niya, yung liberation, hindi naman left and naman, but they wanted to impose yung mga human rights, but then they went around the world, State Department offering assistance to countries which would allow same-sex marriage. Punta ng Liberia, pati tayo dito, anak nang... ako, my human being, wala akong problema. whatever makes a human being happy, sa kanya yan. Pero tayo may batas eh. I cannot allow it because the family code of the river, of the civil code, yung family relations, nagsabi that a marriage must be a man between a man and a woman. So how can we allow it? Of course, may mga relatives ako na bakla. Pati nga ako noon, bakla eh. Oh. Kalog ang mga. We went to Liberia, offered assistance. Okay, if you want it, we'll give you the aid, but allow same-sex marriage. Because in that State Department, it is convoluted. Why? Because it is multiracial. And that will destroy that country one day. Kanya-kanya silang diskarte doon. Mga Latino doon, mga purist na puti, ganon. So there's no one. That is why Obama said, ito, ikaw, Duterte, do na yung human rights. Nung nanalo si Bush, tinawagan ko siya. So go, Mr. President-elect, this is President Duterte of the Philippines. May I congratulate you on your... Trump. Tapos sabi ni Trump, oh yeah, I've heard, I was expecting a call. You are right, this goddamn son of a bitch is destroying my country. He mentioned a country somewhere nearby. You know, when I get there, I'm gonna get rid of them. Sabi ko, saan tayo pupunta nito? Yung isang presidente, i-reprimand. Ito namang isa, you are priestess to the heaven. Yan ang Amerika. Anak ng putang. Tapos pakialaman nila, 4 million addicts. Sila mismo ang forensics nila nagsabi na constant use of shabu will shrink the brain. So, what am I supposed to do? Iintrigahan nila ako na Duterte mag-ano yan, mag-marsyalo yan. No, you'll stay in power, tangina. Kung gusto mo na, umulis na ako ngayon. Tinamad na ako. Tapos, I do not get this. My rage, my dedication, my mental health, paradigm ko, it's in my oath of office. If you read the whole of the oath of office of the president, it simply is reduced to the barest minimum. It says, I must protect and preserve the Filipino nation, period. Gawain ko ang gusto ko kung ano ang inutos ng oath of office ko. Walang pakialam dyan sa Marcelo na yan. Basta titignan ko, it is my duty to protect and preserve the Filipino. If you destroy my country, hindi tayo mayaman eh. When I get old, alam mo yan, Inday, alam mo yan, Danny, nakita mo naman, sabi-sabi lang nila, kita mo naman yung status ko sa buhay sa Davao. I have to depend on my children when I get old. Sila yung magbili ng oxygen ko. Sila yung magbili ng medisina. Some families or most of the families na ano, sabi ninyo nasa middle class, walang middle class dito. Pag nagkasakit ang lola, prenda talaga ng lupa yan, prenda ng ano para lang. Tapos gagaguhin ninyo, magpatayan tayo dyan. Sigurado yan. This campaign will not end until after the drug lord, the last of them will be killed and destroyed. Kasi kung may shabo, may runners, a user is always a poser. So, pag may mga runner, everybody's happy. patayin mo naman ang drug dealer, pero marami pa rin runners, somebody will be tempted to produce kasi pera eh. Yan ang problema. It is an apparatus which I have to destroy. Both, kasi tingnan mo ang Inquirer. Ang sinasabi ko, sila ang may sabi na pinapatay ko raw ang mga mahirap. Alam mo ang Inquirer kahapon, no? Talagang bullshit ang putang ina niya. Basura talaga yan. Ba't yung eleksyon na kaya? The poor will be killed. Tignan ako mag-slant. Ayawang ko ba, but someday, you know, hindi ko tinatakot, but someday yung karma nila dadating. Talagang mga walang hiya ang mga putang inang journalista na yan. Sabihin ko sa iyo, talagang walang hiya, pati yung ABS-CBN. Because if I have the money, putang ina ninyo, nandiyan na ako sa gobyerno ngayon and you can request any son of a bitch there sa Central Bank. Tell them to get a statement. Bakit ako magbigay sa kalaban ko? If there is really 200 million sa account ko, I will resign tomorrow. Yan ang hamon ko sa lahat. And if my children would get involved in corruption, I will gladly step down. Yan ang totoo, mga Inquirer, mga bullshit kayo, pati yung ABS-CBN. Basura yung inano ninyo. Dapat may magsabi sa inyo ngayon, putang ina ninyo, sinubrahan ninyo ang kagalukuhan ninyo. Dapat talaga yung somebody should say, putang ina ninyo. Baka takot magsabi, patakihin mo na unatakihin. Ara-ara-ara, pag makita kitang may-ari, sabihin kita, mukain kita, putang ina mo, bastos ka. Huh? Me? If you ask me that I'm very happy to be president, shit, I'm not. Nagsisi ako. Kasi may mga press pala na putang ina na walang alam kung hindi kasi nung uli. Ano ako? I do not need this at the time of my life. I'm 72. Parami pa ko speculation siya na, mama, may sakit ako na, bakit ang lolo mo? Hindi namatay? Gago talaga ito mga putang. Oy. Kayong mga preto, kayong mga Lopez, did your grandfather live forever? Lul pala kayo. Magpagbuti ang magbabuyan na tayo dito. Eh no, hindi magbabuyan tayo araw-araw. Bakit ba? Yung bang mga lolo ninyo hindi namatay? Ang lamang lang ninyo kasi mayaman kayo. At least they died. Wala man din. At the end of the day, we will be all carcass. Huwag ninyo akong... Kaya 211 billion? Million? Huwag na yung billion, million. Mag-resign ako. Totoo lang. Kalungkatin na ninyo lahat. The life of a worker of government is always open to... Ako, prangkahan ko kayo. Mga bastos rin kayo. Totoo lang. Yung ginagawa ninyo, kabastos. Eh, di ako. Kuha ako ng programa araw-araw dito sa PTV4. Bastosin ko rin kayo. Ganun na lang. Pag sinabi mo, editorial mo, putang ina mo, sabihin ko, putang ina mo rin. Para tabla-tabla tayo. Tingnan natin. Mga mining, so, you know, I won without money. I won ang presidente ko, ang mayor, ang governor ko, si Aime, si Ubet, Garcia sa Bataan, yung isang sa Mindanao na mahal ko. Siyempre, ang love. No, bumaliktad siya, it got 100,000 there. Kaya mas, between a campaign funds and lab, doon kayo sa lab, talagang hindi mo wala. Wala akong, wala ang congressman ko, yung si Nograles lang. Wala akong utang na loob, kaya ako putang ina, hirit. That is why, if you want your country, the ideal country that you want, ngayon na, back up ko kayo lahat. Pag may kurasa na, nabi ko, even a whiff of corruption sa cabinet ko. And used to na itong NEDA, the infamous 3 years, 2 years, 5 years ang application dyan. All cabinet secretaries are only given 1 month to act on the papers. There has to be a routine there na matignan ko, ledger or something. And sa mga directors, toto mga tamad to isa pa, bo manteke sa akin, they are only given 15 days. You must be the first to report and last to leave sa opisina mo. And you must husband the routine of papers. I-husband mo para see to it that after 15 days hindi ka mapasubo. Hindi ako nang ano dito, sinabi ko sa inyo. Pag tinatawag, patawag kita dito, bastosan tayo, either sipain kita or sampalin kita. Ako ipaprangka ko sa inyo, I called all the mayors. Tatlong ganito kalaki, three groups. Nabi ko talaga sa kanya, putang ina, huwag kayong pumasok ng droga, papatayin ko kayo. Talagang papatayin ko kayo. Mamili ka, ambos, sniper. Wag mong sirain ang bayan. If there's anything that would really get my goat, yung sisirain mo yung mga bata. Talo tayo eh. Next generation, medyo limping, if not totally. Pero mo sinong ma-presidente sunod? Kung hindi ko ito matapos, sinong presidente ilalagay mo? Paano niya tapusin? Eh lahat may ang takot makulong. Kung hindi ko ito tapusin, patay ang Pilipino. Kaya tapusin ko talaga to. Kulong? Kulong? Si 22? Isang araw? 22, 23? At that time, wala na rin ako. Totoo. Magay nung picture sa yung birthday ko kasi yung napicturan yung kwarto ko may converter sa oxygen. Karami na namang ano. Di ba sinabi ko sa inyo, I never lied. Tinanong ako doon sa the debates, anong sakit mo? Sabi ko, Barrett dito, sa inom pati ano. Burgers because of smoking. So, ang circulation ko, hindi maganda, lack of oxygenation. Kaya pati pagtulog ko, kasangsag ako. If you want to remain beautiful, use it. It's good. Totoo. That's the sabi ng doktor. Sabi ng mga doktor, use it. Kasi kung babae ka, para gumanda ka lalo, mas maraming temptation. Ako, gagamitin ko yun kasi ang brain ko daw may suffers lack of oxygenation. Matagal ko na ginamit yan. When I said that, wala akong tinago. May nakita nila yung parang oxygen. It's not really an oxygen, it's a converter. Wala man akong tinago. Magtanong sila, ano pang sakit mo? Noon, nung bata pa ako. Siguro mga 5 beses ako balik ng doktor. Pinador. Alam mo na kung ano. Eh, Oil base. Punta ka sa diyan sa Raon. Pagka 3 days after, ayun na, putang ina. Balik na. Sabi ng doktor, tayo na katatlo ka sa isang taon ngayon. Ha? Well, hindi lang kundi ko nang ano, kasi marami pa akong problema ngayon. Ay, at least nakabuga ako, totoo man. Inquirer, you've never been fair. I know that it's supposed to be antagonistic, but fair, you're not. Bastos kayo, pati ABS-CBN, bastos. Bastos talaga. Kasi alam nila, without checking sa the veracity of the truth about, pag-eleksyon na, pera-pera na eh. Kung sino yung makabayad ng pera, yun, publish nila. Kaya itong mga mayan, akala mo mga honest, to mga respected members of society. Okay, mukhang pera yan, mga putang ina yan. Totoo. Kaya ilang mga tao, diver kasi may-ari ng newspaper, may-ari ng baka takihin ka. Well, let us see. Walang. Tapos kung magsalita pa, as if they are really... May sulat ng anak ko doon kay, ano, sino yung buang na bishop na yun? Binigyan ni Inday. Isa pa rin yung mga putang inang pare na yan. Kala mo sila lang, sus! Totoo. Yung basang altar secrets, basahin ninyo. Digo, pag katoliko ka pa bukas, believe na ako sa iyo. That religion will become a passé in the next 30 years. Lalo lalabas na yung mga abuses nila. So, mga pari, numero uno rin yan. Sige lang kulikta, siging kulikta. May second collection pa. Tapos yung sa amin doon, ang asawa niya nandoon sa NHA. Sa housing, dadala ng grocery. Putang inang pari na ito, let's see. Yan ang. That what ails the Philippine society. It's the corrupt media. Yung muka ng La Prieto, pati Lopez ng pera, at yung simbahan. The oligarchs of this country. May enjoyment sila, 1% only, panahon pa ni Cory Aquino. Hanggang dumating na lang sa akin, sabi ko, this is... Kaya pinatawag ko yung Jacklam na yun. Pero lulusot yun sa intelligence yung pinagsasabi ng ulule. Sabi niya na ano, everybody in the Philippines was in his pocket. Puta, tinawagan, kulihin mo. Sabi ni NBI, anong charge? Putang ina, walang charge. Patayin mo pag walang charge. Litsing yan. Butit na lang, 3 days before, nakasibat na ang unggoy. Pag naabutan kita, walang tanong-tanong ka, itapon mo sa Pasig, yon ang charge mo. You know, I want to be as decent as I can ever be. I want to be on the socially correct. I know how to behave. Nung buhay pa nanay ko, I cannot talk about. Nung buhay pa nanay ko, hindi ko kaya magbuga-buga ng ganito. Pero minsan kasi, ang ating society has to know the truth. Kung ano ang laro natin lahat. Ako, wala akong problema. Babae, marami akong babae. Pati yung mga asawa ninyo, marami man rin yung lilang babae. Hindi lang ninyo alam. Ganun lang yan ang buhay sa totohanan. So, siguro dito sa lahat ng lalaki, I'll peg you at about mga... Okay, but mga 300. May sabi, sinong mabait dyan na walang kabit? Dalawa-tatlo lang siguro. Isa nito si Chairman Duque. Diyang hirang, dalawang beses niya nag-asawa. Sino ba ba? Mike Ayala, dalawang beses rin. Sino pa? Wala talagang matino dito. Salamat that I still have to...